Whenever I'm asked to consult on a patient with a wound issue, I take a wound management approach to that patient, starting off with a thorough clinical assessment, and not just assessment of the patient, but overall appraisal and assessment of the patient, followed by diagnostic measures as needed, then leading to consideration of what therapeutic options are available for that patient, but also considering what that patient what that patient's wound means in terms of their prognosis, ability to heal, and what does that wound mean and imply in terms of the patient's overall survival. And also looking towards secondary prevention, because so when I speak of prevention, I also speak of primary and secondary prevention. So when we see a patient who doesn't have any wound issues, when we if we were to observe a patient with a very low level of performance status or a very rapidly declining level of performance status, that is a patient who's at prime time for development of a new pressure lesion, for instance. But that very patient is also liable to get other lesions. So in a patient with an existing wound, we need to think preventatively in a secondary way. So we need to focus not only on primary prevention, but also secondary prevention of wounds. The management of pain is one of the therapeutic aspects of wound management. And patients with wounds have untold suffering with respect to pain. In fact, pain is the number one symptom in malignant wounds. And pain in wounds in general can be defined as baseline pain and also incident pain, namely procedurally induced pain that occurs when dressings are removed, when dressings are reapplied, when wounds are cleansed, and also when wounds are debrided. Incident pain is generally very poorly managed, but we do have some new options for the management of incident pain, namely the volitional incident pain that occurs when healthcare practitioners are dressing wounds, cleansing wounds, and debriding them. And probably the optimal management for the prevention and treatment of procedural incident pain is the short-acting, rapid-onset fentanyl series of drugs. Those of us who see a lot of wounds have been using the intravenous formulation of fentanyl sublingually, preemptively, 5 or 10 minutes prior to a procedure like a dressing change or a debridement. And a number of novel agents are now on the market, approved by Health Canada, that allow for a sublingual or intrabuccal or intranasal administration preemptively to prevent incident pain, because it is a massive problem. The TSAS tool, or the Toronto Symptom Assessment System for Wounds, is a scoring system to assess the physical symptoms associated with wounds. It was modeled after the ESAS, which is more of a global symptom assessment system for patients as a whole. But wounds, the suffering, the physical symptoms that the wound itself produces for the patient can be quantified and measured through the use of TSAS. One of the features of TSAS is that it's applicable to all wounds. There's a proliferation of different tools in the literature that cater to one form of wound or another form of wound, and TSAS hopefully is an effort to try to unify the systems and instruments and tools that are used to quantify the physical symptom burden. And I emphasize the physical symptoms. TSAS does not measure the psychosocial impact, the spiritual and the existential, etc. It's strictly physical. And the various metrics that compose TSAS can be summed to calculate a global wound symptom distress score. And our hope is that TSAS can be used not only to guide our clinical care of patients, but also maybe useful as a research tool to be able to measure novel therapies that help with the overall theme of wound palliation. So in summary, TSAS-W is is a scoring system, is an instrument or tool that can be used to assess our performance in what I call wound palliation, which is dealing with wound-related pain and symptom management. Wound palliation essentially is the management of pain and symptoms related to the wound itself. Although wound palliation traditionally has dealt with the physical symptoms, we're now recognizing that there are non-physical dimensions to wound palliation as well, namely the relief of psychosocial, spiritual, and existential distress related to the wound itself. Traditionally, we've thought of it in strictly a physical domain, on a physical strata, but we now recognize that wound palliation also needs to encompass the non-physical aspects of the wound, namely the psychosocial, spiritual, and existential aspects.